I've never really wanted to sit back and relax. It's important for me to keep in the ring and punching and boxing, and that's what I'm doing.
Well, for me, being an artist is all about being creative and moving forward, you know, and constantly exploring all the possibilities and the potential that's available to you. I just felt that it was important to go off and do something that was going to take a different direction musically and create a new sound.
It ain't about being a fashion statement or a trendsetter for me. It's just being where you're at now musically, but at the same time trying to stretch, trying to push and move into other areas that haven't been gotten into musically.
What I will tell you I'm hoping to do is really bizarre, extreme, radical, crazy vocal things that I've never done before. Real shredding stuff, you know. I can't wait to get in the studio and let rip. This gives me an opportunity for the Priest fans to see what Rob Halford is about, to let them get a closer understanding of what I perceive my idea of metal to be. For the most part, that has always been very, very hardcore, very radical, sometimes risky, and to have no compromise in it, you know. What you'll get from me will be from the guts, it'll be heartfelt metal, and, you know, I just hope everybody likes what I'm about to do.
Check.
The strangest thing about meeting this guy is that he was doing tattoo work on me, and I found out that Jay played bass. He'd come down from the Midwest, from Toledo, Ohio, with Brian. We got to talking, and I went and seen these guys play, and I was just knocked out by what Jay Jay was doing. It has to connect with me instantly. My attention span is about 2 seconds, and I know right away if there's something there. And that's what hit me straight away about Jay Jay. I knew Ross through some friends out in California.
We try real hard. We could be a top contending band for one of the loudest bands in the world.
Woo! Hello, hello. Chick, chick, chick. 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 Chick, chick, chick.
The drums accompanied with the bass is what really kind of glues the whole thing together. Scott's the best man that I know of. He is just probably the greatest drummer in the world today for this style of music.
This band's going places.
I don't think anybody knew what it was going to sound like until we actually got together and played. Just a real trip from the beginning of the band coming together, from the first demos in Phoenix when this band jammed for the first day.
I am absolutely staggered by the incredible competency of the musicians in this band. To me, it just reflects on the new breed of musician, that they're so advanced that they don't need to go through months or years of development.
The thing about this band is that everybody's got this terrific talent and everybody knows what needs to be done.
The intensity and the attitude and the performance is there right from the moment these guys switch on their amplifiers. I'm going to really hit people for six with some of the vocal ideas that I've been working on.
Be a
cool idea to take us all out of one country and put us in a location and get to know each other. And so we were really focusing and getting very intense in the studio, being really spontaneous and creative, and so that's why we went over to Holland to make the record.
This is Eddie, a world famous producer plus driver. See, there's a stereo.
I'm a taxi. Actually, I'm famous for my taxi service.
Ah. Anti Bauer, who co-produced the record with us, he works on the Priest Painkiller album. He's just a brilliant, brilliant, talented man, you know. He's got great perception to getting all the tones and the dynamics and the important things that you need to make to get a record happening.
That's awesome.
Gotta keep that effect.
God, is that evil.
Sick. We are sick.
It was just a real blast when we made this record over in Holland. It was just a great experience, and there was a lot of creativity flying in the studio. The work proper for me didn't really happen until we got over to Europe and began doing all the stuff that kind of inspires you and comes out as you're actually recording, you know? Like all the lead work that Russ and that Brian did, a lot of that was spontaneous. And that's the way I think it is, a good way to capture that inspiration and that kind of magic that comes from doing things as they kind of hit you in the head.
It was really laid back, you know. I was really nervous before I got there. I never made a major label album before, you know, but everything, we worked really well together and everybody was cool with each other and there was no pressure, you know. It was really nice.
Jay?
What?
Can you do your bass again? Or your mortal sin?
We were all foreigners in a foreign land, so we did bond and stay together, which I think is better than maybe being in a place, whether it be your hometown like LA or Phoenix or wherever, and then people just go their own ways and you don't get a chance, especially because we were all new. I mean, we hadn't spent any time together. And it was Amsterdam, so there was plenty of times and places to unwind after the session. It's immortal sin. It's immortal
sin. It's immortal sin. The fight came together and Scott and Russ and JJ and Brian, everybody kicked butt in the studio in Amsterdam and got it down onto CD, and now we're ready to play to the world.
Check.
The cool thing about playing this place in Phoenix is that you really are about as close as physically possible to connect to your audience because they're right in your face. That's the way this band totally communicates under those conditions.
The benefit of playing places like this is that you do get that immediate feedback and you can just feel the heat, you know, off everyone, and it's pretty cool.
When I came across the word fight, it seemed to increase
incorporate all of the virtues of what I think being in a band is about, which is struggling to overcome any obstacles that come in your way. Fight in any way, to me, is a very positive thing. It's not a negative, destructive thing. So all the attributes surrounding the word fight were perfect for what this band sets out to present itself as musically and in its attitude, in its sense and beliefs and desires. From a visual performance, I think people are going to be extremely excited and very, very stimulated by the way this band performs on stage. We want to make people not only listen, but we want to make people think. We want to be provocative. We want to create reaction.
It's all about making people think and just provoking people, exciting them. Making them angry, just creating all this kind of turbulent emotion in people's heads.
It ain't about how many lights you've got and how many fucking stage clothes you're going to wear and how beautiful your hair looks anymore. You know, it's just going out there and playing it from the heart.
See a world of suffering, money sucking greed.
This band is no different to the people in the crowd, it's just that we play the instruments, you know, but we're absolutely together, connected with the music. Like fans around the world are going to really be able to get into this band and know that we're being real about what we do.
I really enjoy playing live, being able to release myself that much to all those people is just amazing.
It's all about reality, and that's what I love about this new generation of musicians and fans. We're just going out there with the back line and sticking the power on and just doing the business, and that's the way it should be. The thing about fights is that none of it's preconceived, none of it's like premeditated, like let's make this and let's like sound like this and let's be this way and that way. There's no formula, there's no book you can get out of the fucking library to like say, well, how does this work? A lot of it's hit and miss, but with us it's just clicked from day one.
Live in our interactive studios via virtual reality, a worldwide mega platinum artist in a brand new setting, Rob Halford of the group Fight. Rob, why don't you start by telling us about Fight?
I guess that first of all, it's important to most people to understand that this is a great journey that I'm about to take on, a new adventure, and one that I'm greatly looking forward to. Musically, it's a great stretch. It's exciting, it's powerful, it's strong, it's dramatic. Collectively, we've attempted to break new ground. That's something I've always been a strong believer in. Touring, well, so that'll begin probably around October, November through December. 94 shows us going into areas that I've never really had the opportunity to explore. This band's going to play anywhere we can plug in amplifiers, I can tell you that. And I look forward to trying to meet as many people as possible as we go around the world and having a great time together. Let's get ready to rumble and let the fight begin. Thank you.